blessings and giver of life, come and abide, cleanse every stain, and save our souls, O gracious one. Ο Θεός, κατά το μέγα έλεος σου δεωμεθά σου επάκουσον και ελέησον.
Κύριε Ιησού, Κύριε Ιησού, Κύριε Ιησού. Έτι δεωμεθά υπέρ των ευσεβών και ορθοδόξων χριστιανών.
Κύριε Ιησού, Κύριε Ιησού, Κύριε Ιησού.
Έτι δεωμεθά υπέρ του αρχιεπισκόπου ημών Κωνσταντίνου. Again we pray for our Archbishop Constantine. Έτι δεωμεθά υπέρ του αρχιεπισκόπου και πατριάρχου ημών Βορθολομαίου και πάσης εις εν Χριστώ ημών αδερφότητος. Again we pray for our Archbishop and Ecumenical Patriarch Bartholomew and for all our brotherhood in Christ.
Again we pray for mercy, life, peace, health, salvation, visitation, pardon and remission of the sins of the servants of God, all pious and orthodox Christians residing and visiting this city and this eparchy, the council members, trustees, benefactors, sponsors and donors of all the parishes, holy monasteries, sacred institutions, and its good-ordered educational and charitable organizations, and all our brothers and sisters who are gathered here with us in this sacred service.
Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison.
Again, we pray for the protection of the Holy and Great Church of Christ, our sacred archdiocese, this holy metropolis and city, and every city and land, from wrath, famine, pestilence, earthquake, flood, fire, sword, foreign invasion, civil strife, and accidental death, that our good and loving God may be merciful and gracious and kindly disposed, and may divert and disperse all anger and disease coming against us, and deliver us from his impending righteous chastisement, and have mercy on us.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray that the Lord our God will hear the voice of the prayers of us sinners and have mercy on us.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Hear us, O God, the Redeemer, the hope of those at the ends of the earth and those away at sea. Be gracious toward our sins, Master, and have mercy on us. For you are a merciful God who loves mankind, and to you we ascribe glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Glory to our God, and our hope, glory to you. May he who sent the all-holy Spirit as tongues of fire upon the holy disciples and apostles, Christ our true God, at the intercessions of his all-pure and all-immaculate Holy Mother, the power of the precious and life-giving cross, the protection of the honorable bodiless powers of heaven, the supplications of the honorable glorious prophet and forerunner John the Baptist, of the holy glorious and all-praiseworthy apostles, the holy glorious and triumphant martyrs, of our righteous and God-bearing fathers, of the holy righteous ancestors of the God Joachim and Anna, of the holy higher martyrs Eusebius, Bishop of Samosata, the holy martyrs Zeno and Zenos, whose memory commemorate today and of all your saints, have mercy on us and save us, for he is a good God who loves mankind. Be attentive.
Βαρθολομαίος Ελέου Θεού Αρχιεπίσκοπος Κωνσταντινουπόλεως Νέας Ρώμης και Οικουμενικός Πατριάρχης. Ευλαβέστατοι ιερείς, οσιότατοι ιερομόναχοι και απαξάπαντες οι κληρικοί, τιμιότατοι επίτροποι, πρόκριτοι και ευλογημένοι χριστιανοί της Αγιωτάτης Μητροπόλεως Denver, της Ιεράς Αρχιεπισκοπής Αμερικής, τέκνα της ημών μετριότητος εν Κυρίω αγαπητά, χάρις ή ημίν και ειρήνη παρα Θεού, παρημών δε ευχή, ευλογία και συγχώρησης. Έστω γνωστόν πάσιν ημίν, ότι της Ιεράς ημών Μητροπόλεως απροστατεύτου διαμηνάσεις, άτε του εναυτή αρχιερατεύοντος Μητροπολίτου Κυρίου Ισαΐου, μετατεθέντος εις την Ιεράν Μητρόπολη Λύστρων, η Μήτυρ Αγία του Χριστού Μεγάλη Εκκλησία, εκ πολλής προς ημάς αγάπης και κατοφιλήν αξιόκρεων, έλαβε μέρημναν περί τούτου, η δε η Μετέρα Μετριώτης, μετά της περί ημάς Αγίας και Ιεράς Συνόδου, προήλθομεν συνοδά και την προτάση της Ιεράς Επαρχιακής Συνόδου της Ιεράς Αρχιεπίσκοπης Αμερικής, εις εκλογήν και αποκατάστασιν εν τη επαρχία ταύτη αρχιερέως ικανού δυναμένου αισίως και λυσιτελώς διεξαγαγήν το έργον της εκκλησιαστικής διοικήσεως και κατά Χριστόν διαπημάνσεως ημών. Ψήφων τίνην κανονικών γενωμένων εν το καθημάς πανσέπτο πατριαρχικό ναό του Αγίου Μεγαλομάρτυρος Γεωργίου του Τροπεοφόρου, η Μετέρα Πατριαρχική Προτροπή και Αδεία υπό της περί ημάς Αγίας και Ιεράς Συνόδου, τη επικλήση του Παναγίου και Τελεταρχικού Πνεύματος, εις εκλογήν και ανάδειξην του αξίου εκ των τεθέντων τριών υποψηφίων προσώπου προς ανάληψην της αρχιερατικής προστασίας και ποιμαντικής ράβδου της επαρχίας ημών, προεκδίθη των άλλων και εξελέγει ο Θεοφιλέστατος Επίσκοπος Σασίμων κύριος Κωνσταντίνος, ανήρ κόσμιος, της ήθεση και ιεροπρεπής. Τα θεία καλός εξισκημένος, παιδεία και κοσμημένος εκκλησιαστικήτε και τυφύραθεν, φρονήσει και ικανότητη συγκεκροτημένος και πήραν ου μικράν έχων των εκκλησιαστικών πραγμάτων και υποθέσεων εκ της άχρητου δε μακράς δοκίμου και τετιμημένης εν διεκκλησία διακονίας αυτού. Ως και ανεδείχθη γνήσιος και κανονικός Μητροπολίτης της Αγιωτάτης Μητροπόλεως Denver της Ιεράς Αρχιεπισκοπής Αμερικής. Όθεν και δια του παρόντος Πατριαρχικού ημών και Συνοδικού Γράμματος κοινοποιούντες τούτο πάσιν ημίν της εν τη Ιερά Μητροπόλη Denver αγαπητής ημίν και ευλογημένης Χριστιανής, ευχόμεθα και ευλογούμεν πατρικός και εντελώμεθα και παραγγέλωμεν εκκλησιαστικός, όπως τον διαλειφθέντα ιερότατον Μητροπολίτην Denver, λίαν διμήν αγαπητών εν Χριστώ αδελφών και συλλειτουργών κύριων Κωνσταντίνων, γινώσκητε από τούδε γνήσιον, νόμιμων και κανονικών αρχιερέα ημών και ευαγγελικών ποιμένα και πατέρα πνευματικών απάντων ημών και μνημονεύεται ή από του ιερού καταλόγου του κανονικού αυτού ονόματος ως νενόμιστε εν πάσες τες ιερές τελετές και ακολουθίες πειθόμενοι οι πάντες και υποτασσόμενοι τες αρχιερατικές αυτού υποθήκες και συμβουλές ως αφορώσες εις την ψυχικήν ημών ωφέλειαν και την φυλακήν των πατρών δογμάτων και παραδόσεων. Επί δε τούτης απονέμοντες πάσιν ημίν ολόθυμων την πατριαρχικήν και πατρικήν ημών ευλογίαν, ευχόμεθα ημίν και της οίκης ημών πλούσια πάντοτε τα δωρήματα του δοτήρος πάντος αγαθού Κυρίου και σωτήρος ημών, ου η χάρις και το άπειρον έλεος ίσαν με τα πάντων ημών. Εν έτη σωτηρίο, δις χιλιοστό 24ο κατά μήνα Μάιον 17ης επινεμήσεως Δευτέρας ο Κωνσταντινουπόλεος Βαρθολομαίος αποφαίνεται. Ο Καναδά Σωτήριος, ο Λαοδικίας Θεοδόρητος, ο Κορέας Αμβρόσιος, ο Αυστρίας Αρσένιος, ο Σίμης Χρυσόστομος, ο Ρεθύμνης και Αυλοποτάμου Πρόδρομος, ο Ανέων Μακάριος, ο Κρήτης Ευγένιος, ο Κόου και Νησίρουν Αθαναήλ, ο Νέας Ιερσέης Απόστολος, ο Σικάγουν Αθαναήλ, ο Σελευκίας Θεόδωρος. Most Reverend Priests, Most Pious Higher Monks and All Clergy, Most Honorable Members of the Metropolitan and Parish Councils, distinguished and blessed Christians of the Most Holy Metropolis of Denver, of the Sacred Archdiocese of America, our beloved children in the Lord, may you have grace and peace from God and from us, prayer, blessing, and forgiveness. Let it be known to all of you that since your sacred metropolis has found herself without a shepherd, when the archpriest in the metropolis of Denver, His Eminence Metropolitan Isaiah, was transferred to the holy metropolis of Lystra, the Mother, Holy and Great Church of Christ, out of her great love for you and infinite obligation to you, has shown concern in this matter, and our humble person, together with the Holy and Sacred Synod, has proceeded in accordance with the recommendation of the Sacred Eparchial Synod of the Sacred Archdiocese of America to the election and restoration in this eparchy of a capable hierarch who can successfully and profitably carry out the work of governing the Church and shepherding you in Christ. When, therefore, out at our patriarchal exhortation and consent, the Holy and Sacred Synod gathered around us in the Sacred Patriarchal Church of St. George, the Trophy Bearer, and with the invocation of the All-Holy and Consecrating Spirit conducted the canonical votes for the election and appointment from among the three proposed candidates of the person that would be worthy to take up the hierarchical leadership and the pastoral staff of your eparchy, the one preferred over the others and elected was His Grace Bishop Constantine of Sasima, a man decent in his manners and solemn in his priestly conduct, well-versed in divine matters, distinguished in both his ecclesiastical and his secular education, disciplined in thought and capability, and not inexperienced in ecclesiastical matters and affairs from his heretofore long, tested and honorable service in the Church, who has now been proclaimed the rightful and canonical Metropolitan of the Most Holy Metropolis of Denver of the Sacred Archdiocese of America. Wherefore, even as we convey this news through our present patriarchal and synodal letter to all of you, our beloved and blessed Christians in the Sacred Metropolis of Denver, as your spiritual father, we pray and bless, and in accordance with ecclesiastical order, we enjoin and exhort that you henceforth recognize the aforementioned most reverend Metropolitan of Denver, our most beloved brother and concelebrant in Christ, Constantine, as your genuine, lawful, and canonical hierarch, and evangelical shepherd, and spiritual father of all of you, and that those of you in the ranks of the priesthood commemorate his canonical name as is customary in all your sacred ceremonies and services, and that you all obey and submit yourselves to his hierarchical instructions and counsels, inasmuch as they pertain to your spiritual benefit and the preservation of the teachings and traditions of our fathers. Moreover, as we impart to all of you our wholehearted patriarchal and paternal blessing, we pray that you and your households may always enjoy the rich gifts of the giver of every good thing, our Lord and Savior, whose grace and infinite mercy be with you all. In the year of our Lord, 2024, in the month of May 17th, of the second year of the present indiction, Bartholomew of Constantinople and the Ecumenical Patriarch decides, Sotirios of Canada, Theodoritos of Laodicea, Ambrosius of Korea, Arsenius of Austria, Chrysostomos of Simi, Prodromos of Rethymnon and Avlopotamos, Macarios of Anion, Evgenios of Crete, Nathaniel of Kos and Nisiros, Apostolos of New Jersey, Nathaniel of Chicago, Theodoros of Cilicia.
Today, we gather to offer doxology for all things that we receive from the Lord, joyous moments, but also moments of pain and sadness. And before I offer my remarks, I would be remiss if I don't remember what His Eminence Constantine might be going through right now with the loss of his brother John. May his memory be eternal. Your Eminence Metropolitan Gregory of Nyssa, representative of His All Holiness Ecumenical Patriarch Bartholomew, Your Eminence beloved brother Archbishop Elpidophoros of America, President of our Holy Eparchial Synod and Exarch of the Ecumenical Patriarchate in America, Your Eminences Apostolos of New Jersey and Constantine of Denver, Brother Hierarchs, Presbyters, Deacons, Monastics, Brethren, Christ is in our midst.
He is and always shall be.
We gather today to celebrate the enthronement of His Eminence Metropolitan Constantine of Denver. This is a moment of joy and gratitude for our church. Above all, we give glory and thanksgiving to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the High Priest of the Church, for guiding us to this precise moment in history that will have lasting impact for generations to come. We also express our special gratitude to His All Holiness, our spiritual father and ecumenical patriarch Bartholomew, and the members of the Holy and Sacred Synod of the Patriarchate of Constantinople for their God-inspired decision to elect Metropolitan Constantine as the next Metropolitan of Denver. Their discernment and love have provided a chief shepherd who will guide you with faith, integrity, and dedication. We extend heartfelt acknowledgement to His Eminence Metropolitan Isaiah, who has faithfully shepherded the Denver Metropolis family for over 3 decades. His spiritual guidance has profoundly impacted this community, leaving an enduring Christ-inspired legacy. As Metropolitan Constantine assumes his rightful place on his hierarchical throne, we are reminded of the sacred ascent of our Lord Jesus Christ, who ascended into the heavens 40 days after His resurrection, to assume His rightful place at the right hand of God the Father. This parallel highlights the divine guidance and blessing that accompanies Metropolitan Constantine as he begins his archpastoral ministry as your Metropolitan. Just as Christ's ascension was a sign of His eternal presence and love for the world, we have faith that Metropolitan Constantine's leadership will be underpinned by divine grace and strength. The Blessed Metropolis of Denver is a vibrant and diverse community, encompassing the faithful from 14 states: New Mexico, Utah, Oklahoma, Nebraska, North Dakota, South Dakota, Montana, Kansas, Idaho, Wyoming, the western parts of Louisiana and Missouri, and of course, the great state of Texas. We can't forget about Texas. Each state contributes uniquely to the life of the church and of our sacred archdiocese. Colorado, its majestic mountains and strong sense of community remind us of the heights of faith we strive to reach. New Mexico, rich in cultural heritage and artistic spirit, it reflects the beauty and creativity that God instills in His creation. Utah, the stunning landscape and commitment to family values symbolize the nurturing environment of our faith. Oklahoma, the resilience and strength of its people echo the steadfastness we are called to exhibit in our own spiritual lives. Nebraska, known for its agricultural abundance, it symbolizes the fruitful harvest that comes from the life devoted to Christ. North Dakota, the wide open spaces and clear skies reflect the clarity and freedom found in living a life of faith. South Dakota, with its historic landmarks, it reminds us of the importance of our spiritual heritage and traditions. Montana, my personal favorite, the pristine wilderness and tranquil environment symbolize the peace and serenity we find in God's presence. Kansas, its heartland values and industrious spirit reflect the dedication and hard work we put into our spiritual growth. Idaho, with its rugged landscapes and pioneering spirit, it symbolizes the adventurous journey of faith and the discovery of God's wonders. Wyoming, the vast open plains and natural beauty symbolize the expansive love of God and the freedom we find in His embrace. Western Louisiana, known for its rich cultural heritage and hospitality, it reminds us of the warmth and generosity that should characterize our Christian fellowship. Western Missouri, With its historical significance of diverse landscapes, it symbolizes the deep roots and varied expressions of our faith. In Texas, its vastness and bold spirit remind us of the boundless love of God and the courage we must have in our faith journey. To my dear brother Constantine, I wish you a spiritually fruitful archpastoral ministry, always drawing inspiration from the diverse gifts of your flock. Your ascent to this role is a testament to your faith, patience, and dedication to Christ and his people. Please know that you can always count on me. I will remain by your side, offering support and friendship. May God grant you many years of health, wisdom, and spiritual fulfillment as you lead the metropolis of Denver. May your ministry be blessed, and may you continue to inspire and guide the faithful with love and compassion. Amen.
Your Eminence, Metropolitan Constantine of Denver, our beloved brother and concelebrant in the Holy Spirit, may the grace and peace of God be with you. Today you ascend the throne of the Holy Metropolis of Denver in order to assume pastoral responsibility for and spiritual guidance of a vital and distinguished region of the plenitude of the Holy Archdiocese of America and the Exarchate of the Holy Great Church of Christ. The honor bestowed upon you is profound, as it is also the immense responsibility that you now bear before God and his people. God's grace has spoken through the fraternal proposal of the Episcopal Synod of the Holy Archdiocese and through the unanimous canonical election by the Holy and Sacred Synod of the Ecumenical Patriarchate. And so from this day and this hour, you commence your pastoral ministry to the faithful flock of this God-protected metropolis. In this new calling, you have the support of your Archbishop and Chairman of the Holy Eparchial Synod, who has loved and nurtured you over the last years. You also have the support of your brother metropolitans and members of the Holy Eparchial Synod. Both your Archbishop and your brother metropolitans stand fervently beside you in your noble and weighty duties. And of course, you have the experience of a long and rich ministry in various capacities within the vineyard of the Lord, but especially as presbyter and archimandrite at the cathedral in Baltimore, Maryland, and more recently as auxiliary bishop of Sazima, and from which position you assisted your widely esteemed and deeply cherished predecessor, His Eminence Metropolitan Isaiah of Lystra, who has bequeathed to you a loving and lasting legacy in this vast and blessed region. Above all, however, dear brother in Christ, you have the commitment and commendation of the people of God, who have respected and honored you throughout your service. It was the voice of the clergy and the laity of the Holy Metropolis of Denver that God heeded in the last months through the mediation of the locum tenens, His Eminence Metropolitan Nathaniel of Chicago. Therefore, your priestly experience and theological education will inspire you at all times. Your compassion and understanding for God's people will pertain a positive and constructive ministry. And beyond all these, Holy Scripture and Divine Liturgy, along with the Church Fathers and the communion of the saints, will strengthen you at every step as you instruct and inspire your flock. We paternally and wholeheartedly urge you to stand beside the faithful entrusted to your care, directing them as they encounter the numerous and diverse challenges of the contemporary world. Your pastoral ministry should profess and witness to the deep, the depth and breadth of the incarnation of our Lord, who gave his life, as Saint Basil the Great declares in his divine liturgy, for the life of the world, so that the world may have life and life in abundance. Perhaps more so than any other time in history, our age demands a great deal of the religious ministers. It is our responsibility, your responsibility, to reach into the depths of people's hearts in order to shine the light of Christ. It is our obligation, indeed, your obligation, to lead people away from oppression and division to freedom and communion. It is our vocation, and certainly your vocation, dearest brother, to avoid every temptation of secular power and authority, instead becoming a model of compassion and humility. Finally, it is our struggle, and will always be your struggle, as the enthroned metropolitan of this sacred metropolis, to adopt the ecumenical openness that characterizes the Church of Constantinople through the centuries, in times of triumph as well as times of turmoil, in times of success and in times of suffering. This is the only way that the Church can sanctify and transform every human life and the entire creation in order that God's will may be done on earth as it is in heaven. May our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ continue to bless you in this sacred task for the glory of God and for the benefit of his people. Axios! At the Ecumenical Patriarchate on June 21st, 2024, your beloved brother in the Lord, Bartholomew, Archbishop of Constantinople, New Rome, and Ecumenical Patriarch.
Your Eminence, Metropolitan Gregory, representative of His All Holiness, our Ecumenical Patriarch Bartholomew. Your Eminence, Metropolitan Constantine of Denver, beloved brother in the Lord. Your Eminence, Metropolitan Nathanael, who served with integrity and honor as the locum tenens of this metropolis. Your Eminences and Graces, most reverend brothers of the Holy Eparchial Synod. Your Eminences and Graces, concelebrants in the Holy Spirit, representing our sister Orthodox churches. Your Eminences and most reverend hierarchs, representing our sister Christian churches. Very reverend and reverend clergy, presbyters, archons, beloved sisters and brothers in Christ. Today is a day of joy, day of cause of rejoicing for the sacred and God-saved metropolis of Denver. For by the godly act of His All Holiness, our Ecumenical Patriarch Bartholomew, and of course the Holy and Sacred Synod of the Ecumenical Patriarchate of Constantinople, we are gathered today to enthrone the ruling hierarch of this ecclesiastical domain, His Eminence, Metropolitan Constantine of Denver. Axios! This most happy occasion has special resonance for me also personally, for it perfectly coincides with the fifth anniversary of my own enthronement as Archbishop of America. I celebrate with you, my dear brother, Metropolitan Constantine, And I rejoice that for many years to come, I hope, we shall look at June 22nd as a shared milestone and a cause for jubilee. It also seems to be meet and right that your enthronement occurs on the eve of Pentecost, when we remember all those who have come before us, the spiritual giants of love, giants of mercy, on whose shoulders we all stand. It also does not escape us that your Eminence's enthronement, as His Eminence Metropolitan Nathaniel already said, your enthronement comes just days before you will preside at the funeral of your older brother, John. Therefore, on this Psychosabbaton, we hold a special place for him and for you, as you yet grieve, but as one with hope in resurrection. May his memory be eternal. Na ine aeonia in limitu. Your enthronement, brother, comes also just 2 days after the summer solstice, when the light begins to fade a little earlier a day, every day, even though our perception is of longer evenings of solar radiance. The Church knows well by its liturgical wisdom that this time of the year has a special significance, for it places the nativity of the Holy Baptist and forerunner John in these days on the 24th of June. And why? Because, as he said of himself in response to his own disciples, convincing them to follow the new rabbi, the one he had baptized in the River Jordan, ekimon di avxanin emede elatuste, which means he must increase and I must decrease. Here is a message for you, Your Eminence, and for all of us, of course, who dare to shepherd the flock of the great shepherd and the rational sheep. We are called to magnify the presence, the purpose, and the preeminence of our Lord Jesus Christ in the lives of the faithful. Our Lord must increase. He is the Son of Righteousness, illumining every corner of the soul's deepest recess. We are like the moon. We only reflect his glory. Sometimes we wane, sometimes we wax, but the light is always that of Christ, the Lord of glory. Therefore, beloved brother in Christ, and consolable in the Holy Spirit that we are going to celebrate in a few days, let your light shine before all your devout and loving people, that they may see your good works and glorify our Father who is in heaven. Thus, the light of Christ will dawn in their hearts, and the inspiration you instill in them will return to you, will return in their expressions of love, in their expressions of gratitude, and of course, in expressions of support for your God-ordained ministry. Let your example, the sacred person of our ecumenical patriarch, His All Holiness Bartholomew, who has been shown forth to be a good shepherd to the Mikron Pinion of Constantinople, and of course to the entire ecumeny for over 3 decades now. His compassion for those in need, his zeal for righteousness, and his love for all creation are manifestations of the supreme goodness that we all serve. Now, dear brother, you arise from the work of an assistant bishop to that of a ruling metropolitan of the God-protected metropolis of Denver. And this is within the Holy Eparchy of the Archdiocese of America. You are the one who will decide many critical things that will affect your clergy, your faithful, and give a character and flavor to the atmosphere of this metropolis. You have assumed the leadership of the largest metropolis. We heard so beautifully the description and the connectedness that His Eminence Metropolitan Nathanael described us for all the states of this beautiful metropolis, this connection to our faith and the meanings they may have for us. So this is the largest metropolis in terms of square miles, and at the same time, the smallest metropolis in terms of numbers of faithful. It is a challenge. It is a challenge of which I know you are more than capable of shouldering. But you have already served here since your episcopal experience, and which happened in October 2022. But your natural gifts, your episcopal experience, all these will guide you aright as you lead this flock. And remember, shepherd leads from the back of the flock, watching all his sheep until they are safely inside the sheepfold. Stay with them. Remain with them. Abide with them. In their triumphs and their defeats, in their advances and their withdrawals, in their joys and in their sorrows. Be their shepherd and guide them aright in the narrow ways of the Lord, because truth is always more difficult than falsehood, compassion is more strenuous than neglect, and love is more demanding than hatred. This is the ministry of a true pastor, of a shepherd who is willing to sacrifice even his life for the sheep. You have our unconditional support and love, the entire Holy Eparchial Synod. And we shall now add your eloquence and wisdom to that. You have this pious faithful of the metropolis, who have high expectations for your ministry among them, and I know that they shall not be disappointed. They already know you. They are so happy. I still remember the loud and clear voice of clergy and laity in the last clergy-laity assembly here in this metropolis, when your name was clearly expected to be the next shepherd. And the church heard this voice. And I know that your people shall not be disappointed. You shall be a good shepherd to this flock, in imitation of the supreme good shepherd, our Lord Jesus Christ. May you always attain the worthiness of your high office through the grace and mercy of God. Therefore, receive now this staff, this ravelos, not for the correction of your flock, but for their healing. Guide them to the wellsprings of the faith and to the green pastures of pure doctrine with love and compassion, with mercy and forgiveness, that they may ever dwell within the divine fold of the great shepherd of the sheep, our Lord, God, and Savior, Jesus Christ.
Axios!
Axios!
Your Eminence, Archbishop Epitheophorus of America, Your Eminence, Metropolitan Gregory of Nyssa, Patriarchal Representative of His All Holiness, Your Eminence, Metropolitan Nathanael of Chicago, locum tenens for a few more moments. Your Eminence, Metropolitan Apostolos of New Jersey, Your Eminence James Francis Cardinal Stafford of Denver, Bishop Peter Eaton, Your Graces, Reverend Fathers, Presbyteres, and devoted faithful gathered in the sacred Metropolis Cathedral, the Dormition of the Theotokos in Denver, Colorado. I begin by offering my extreme gratitude to His Eminence Archbishop Theodoforos of America, along with the members of the Sacred Eparchial Synod who recommended me to succeed His Eminence Metropolitan Isaiah of Lystra, who served this metropolis with zeal, love, and prayer. I offer my sincere gratitude and thanksgiving to His All Holiness Ecumenical Patriarch Bartholomew and the sacred members of the Holy Synod of Constantinople who elected me as the Metropolitan of Denver. I express my thanks and sincere appreciation to His Eminence Metropolitan Nathaniel of Chicago and His Eminence Metropolitan Apostolos of New Jersey, both of whom serve on the Holy Synod. Upon the vacancy of the sacred throne of the Metropolis of Denver, His Eminence Metropolitan Nathaniel of Chicago assumed the responsibility of locum tenens, took the time to visit the metropolis, our parishes, and to be with our people. As a metropolis, Your Eminence, we thank you, and I personally thank you for always being present during this time of transition. I am also grateful to welcome now to my metropolis, His Eminence Metropolitan Apostolos of New Jersey, my dear friend, co-celebrant, the hierarch who oversaw my former parish of the Annunciation in Baltimore. I also welcome His Grace Bishop Athenagoras of Nunzianzos, His Grace Bishop Nectarius of Dioclea, His Grace Bishop Thomas, His Grace Bishop Andre, who are present and appreciate their prayers and support. I welcome for the first time in meeting His Eminence Cardinal Stafford of Denver. Cardinal Stafford and I share the same birthplace of Baltimore. Your Eminence, we have several faithful here from Charm City. We're here today, and I will know they'll be very pleased to meet you. I am also very grateful to welcome Bishop Peter Eaton from the Episcopal Church, who is a dear friend of His Eminence Metropolitan Isaiah. Your Eminence Archbishop Theodoforos of America, I thank you from the depths of my heart for your encouragement, perseverance, love, and care for me. On behalf of myself and the entire Metropolis of Denver, we keep you in our prayers as you celebrate today your fifth anniversary of your enthronement. Axios. May our Lord and Savior guide you in all things in which you do. Having that understanding of my hierarchical ministry, the first being the liturgical worship, it is through that path that leads us towards His salvation. Not at any time can we be relaxed in any of these circumstances, but strengthened in everything. We are a powerful voice in worship, not an ancient faith, but a continual faith that is unchanging, unadulterated, and what we know to be true. Even in the most difficult times, we find that strength to continue in what God calls us, to be good and faithful servants, spreading the word of Christ to all, and to those who are waiting to hear the good news of Christ is paramount. We cannot be afraid, but rather be strengthened. Our lives today compel us to be empowered by faith. It is done just in singular expression, but always ready and prepared to be those examples of what it means to be an Orthodox Christian. No matter where we find an Orthodox Church, whether in the Rocky Mountains, the Great Plains, or by the warm air of the Gulf of Mexico, our churches are our home. For myself, having the blessing already to visit all of our parishes and monasteries within our sacred metropolis, I rejoice in seeing how God is working. Our people have banded together under the banner of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ to work diligently to keep our churches thriving under the guidance of their priests to worship our Lord. His love for His people is immense, and we are witnesses of this very alive faith. I am grateful for the presence of so many of the clergy of our metropolis, along with visiting clergy. My dear fathers, I've been with you for over a year and visiting your parishes, spending time with you and your family, and along with your parish family, and the future of our metropolis of Denver is very bright. Watching you till the sacred soil of this region and cultivating the faithful to come closer to Christ demonstrates what it means to serve. To each of you, I am grateful to you for your priestly ministry, and for myself, very thankful to be here. Our respected presbyteres, I thank you for everything. The countless times that you have had to readjust your schedules, plan life events around church events, and sharing the attention of your husband with the parish, you are the heroes of our church family. Many times you show tremendous patience as you see your husband leave the house at an odd time for a parish emergency, and caring for your children. You are in my prayers and the prayers of so many. May God give you and your family strength. As clergy families, we will work together and continue to strengthen, educate, cultivate the gifts that have been given to us. My prayers are always with you, and especially to our priests' children. They never ask for this life. Always know that you were in my prayers and the prayers of countless people. I welcome the devout faithful from my former parish of the Annunciation Cathedral in Baltimore, Maryland. As a lifelong member and having served there as a clergyman for one half of my life, I will always be thankful and grateful to you, and I am glad that you are here. Our parishes here in the metropolis of Denver always hear me reference our community, and I will tell you how much I miss you and am gratified by the tremendous memories that we share. What you enabled me to do in cultivating myself and assisting me in the labors in this vast area. My last day, I told you, a year at this cathedral, because of its size, dynamics, locations, demographics, a year could be compared as 5 years elsewhere. I tell you repeatedly, I am fine, and I will never forget you. I also thank the presence of my mom's hometown parish of the Annunciation in Mobile, Alabama, my second home parish, and if you will, a community that I love and respect, and always being grateful to you. To my dear sister Angela, who is not present and at home because of COVID, her beloved husband Eric, and my nephews, my aunt, my mother's cousin, and my own cousins, I am grateful for your presence here today. You never know where life will take you, and I'm glad that we have been on this together. Angela, even though we were separated by miles, we are always together in prayer. I could not have picked a better sister. And I thank you for your love, support, and especially patience. I'm the youngest of three. Angela's in the middle. And you heard my brother John fell asleep in the Lord on Monday. We'll be traveling to Mobile on Tuesday for our brother, and I'm convinced that he is here. We keep his wife, his children, grandchildren in our prayers. St. Nectarius of Aegina is very clear when he teaches, don't let anything deprive you of hope. That hope is in Christ, and that hope is in the resurrection. That hope is in the love of Christ. He is far from specific, but is very clear. I cannot let the day pass without thanking God for my parents, Petros and Stamatia, who gave me the best upbringing, a blessed home, a life that revolved around the church. I thank my former proistamenos that he had the patience to mentor me, Father Constantine Manius of blessed memory. He was known as a priest and a true and faithful servant. I am thankful for a strong relationship with His Excellency Metropolitan Silas of New Jersey of blessed memory, who ordained me both to the diaconate and the priesthood. I also thank the dear clergy and lifelong friends who have traveled to be here and are present in prayer. Our metropolis of Denver has a wonderful future. We have parishes in some of the most remote areas and some of the big cities that are thriving. I am proud to say, and with confidence, that our churches are growing. Parishes and towns that became decimated when the economy changed are on the upswing. People are finding the faith, or they're reverting back to what they knew. Each community has shown the manifestation of our Lord in bringing our faithful closer to Christ. Youth are in the church, accepting leadership positions, bringing their friends and their family back. Folks who left the church for whatever reason are returning, and it is our priests who are using technology and personal contact to interact with and communicate with our faithful. The time is now to plant ourselves firmly in the soil that is waiting to be tilled and God willing, continue to strengthen as a body of Christ, and I'm committed to serving our faithful. The time is now where we as a body of Christ enlighten and encourage our faithful young men to be prepared to attend and graduate our theological school, and be prepared to go into the fields and use those talents that our Lord gifted us and not to bury them. Our theological school is the heart of the church, and we are grateful and thankful that it exists. The visions of generations gone by to establish our own theological school for our archdiocese will do nothing more than strengthen us. And when we are called upon to support our students, there is no choice but to help them in all facets of their upcoming ministry. Our Philoptikos throughout this metropolis most recently hosted the Children's Medical Fund Luncheon, exceeded every expectation, and we are that little engine that could, doing everything that is needed, and no one is forgotten. The time is now for our ladies throughout this metropolis to be strengthened by one another with us, and with one voice to continue to proclaim, as Patriarch Athenagoras said in 1936, the mission promoted by the Philoptikos in many parishes has accomplished miracles. It is through them that we are committed, the labors established from generations that have passed and the ones to come. My dear faithful, the Metropolis of Denver, we take time, especially on a day like this, to thank His Eminence Metropolitan Isaiah of Lystra for over 3 decades of ministry of Christ's Holy Church in the sacred metropolis, aside from his own lifelong ministry of well over 6 decades. He gave himself as a proud churchman and a Marine to serve, semper fidelis, always faithful. The building of the Metropolis Center, the establishment of churches, and now the new camp, through his prayers, labor, and hard work, the baton has been passed to me and to all of us to serve with the love and the zeal of our hearts. I will always be grateful to him, and I know that you also will. I wish to thank from the depths of my heart our Metropolis staff, Father Lou, Presbytero Marcia, Olga, Mary, Elaine, and Pete. We are not a big staff, and I tell you, quite mighty, and I am very grateful to them. I wish to thank this cathedral community, Father Jordan, along with your staff in laboring together for this glorious day in the life of our metropolis. Thank you to the assembled choir, to those serving in the altar, to our young flower girls that were standing outside waiting for my arrival for this beautiful and memorable day. Beloved faithful, I stand here today as your metropolitan with a pounding heart, with knees trembling, and excited to see what God has in store for us. Above everything, keep one another in prayer. Having been here approaching 2 years, not at any time have I ever felt as a foreigner. And the love and embrace that you have shown me in my new home with this sacred metropolis is beyond gratifying. From the travels and getting to know each of you, I thank you every day, and I keep you in my prayers. We are together, and nothing else matters more for us than to be one family in Christ. We are a community of faithful believers that walk together towards salvation, leading us to Christ. My dear brother hierarchs, dear fathers, presbyteros, priest children, philoptikos, archons, Leadership 100, all organizations of the devout faithful, strengthen your faith in all aspects. I look forward to a bright future together and pray that we continue to gain strength from one another and do what is always pleasing to God. May God guide us, sustain us, be with us in all things as we celebrate this weekend the sacred feast of Pentecost. May we be those apostles who are ready to go out and preach the gospel to all nations. Amen.